Hello there. I'm going to show you how you can write validations in Rails in a really reusable way. Right now I have a post where if I type JavaScript, it says the body's invalid. And this is the code I've written so far, which is probably what you've seen before. But what we're going to do is we're going to do it in the way better way. And I'm going to show you this now. So let's kind of jump in. First thing I'm going to do is quickly get rid of this validate because this is not a cool way of doing it. Instead, I'm going to go into here and I'm going to say filter words and pass an array. And let's just say, I don't know, JavaScript is the word we want to filter. And now when I try to submit this form, it's going to say, ah, I don't know this validator. What's going on? This is really cool. So this, we're going to create a reusable validator right now. So let me show you this. So I'm going to quickly go into my app folder. I'm going to create a folder called validators. So there it is. And I'm going to create a file called filter words validator. So let me quickly smash this in. Filter words validator. Nice. Okay, cool. Alrighty. So let's get cracking. So what we're going to use is the active model each validator. We're going to inherit from that. And let me show you what that looks like. So we do active model each validator. And it has this method called validate each, which is cool. Validate each. And it accepts the arguments of a record, an attribute, and a value. Cool. So this is the object we're passing into it to be validated, the attribute we're validating, and the value of that field. Okay, cool. So I'm going to quickly chuck a raisin here, and we're going to have a look at this now. So you can kind of see all of these. Let me just do an array. There you go. So now you're going to be able to see everything which is being passed to this method. So that's very cool. And I think I have to restart Rails quickly to help it pick up on that new file. Okay, let's do this thing. Bam. Cool. So that's our file there. This is everything it's doing. So we've got the post object, which hasn't saved yet, the body, and the value, which is there, which is very cool. Okay, cool. We also have something else we can do in here. There's this value called options. So if I do that again. Sweet. That's very neat. So it's like, okay, this is also what was passed as an argument in our model up here, which is neato. So what we're going to do is we're going to say, okay, return unless value in, I guess, in. Let's say include. And let's say options. In. I think that'll do for now. We're only going to be doing one word. You can play with this JavaScript later and do some neat stuff. Okay, let's add the error here. So let's say record. So that's kind of like we had in that other validator here where we're kind of passing the errors. So let's quickly copy that over. Actually, I'm going to add the errors. We know this attribute is actually the field we wanted. So if we wanted to put it on any other field, we could. And we're going to stick with invalid for now. I think that'll be fine. Let's have a little look-see at what this does now. Okay, no input of array into string. Okay, let's just do like first. That's fine, we can fix this up later. Okay, cool. So it says it's invalid. Let's quickly check this in the title, remove this body. Okay, cool. We were able to validate now that we have something there, which is very nice. But what if we wanted to apply this validation to both the title and the body? Let's do that now. Let's just be that. Just be like, yeah, fill these words. That's cool. All right, you ready? Bam! Both validated. That's really cool. So I really like this approach for like adding custom validators. And I'm going to show you something really cool as well to help you really polish off these. Okay, so this is very cool right now. I like how we could reuse this on different models and form objects, and it will work pretty well. However, it doesn't have any tests around it, and we don't want to ship untested code because that's just really unprofessional. So, how are we going to test this? Well, we could go to our post model and we could add maybe a value for body and containing the word JavaScript and check it has an error on it. And that's fine, that'll work, but if we ever remove this or change the implementation of this filter words, it may not give us a very specific error. So we might be running around our app quite a lot to find out what's actually gone wrong. Instead, I think we can make like a nice unit test around this actual filter, which is very specific to itself, and we go from there. So conveniently, I've set up a bunch of template or Bootstrap stuff you can just copy. And please copy this. It's going to be mentioned in the like linked in the description below. And I've spent like ages trying to like put this together, and like I've used this for a little bit, and it makes me very, very happy. So yeah, take it, use it, love it, all good. Let's go through this. So the first thing we're doing is saying, hey, we want to test this filter words validator, which is very nice. And the subject of our test is a new instance of that particular validator. And we'll come into why I had to add this attributes true thing in just a second. But in this case, there's also this little in argument. That's what we're passing in as an argument, as a forbidden words, or as the list of forbidden words. And we'll play around with this in just a second. The other thing we have here is the errors like object, and that is an active model errors. This there, it can receive the list of errors and it will be very happy. And then the real awesome glue we've got here is we're using an instance double to pretend to be like an active model object, which is very cool, and it only contains the validations and the errors, like enough code to do that. So we've got a very lightweight bit of code there. So if we put this together very quickly, so I'm gonna say subject dot list. So we're gonna say expect subject dot validate each. So let's give this a fake value. Let's call it body. Let's call it body rendered. Like this is completely different from what's in here. We could give this any name and it will just work. And let's say not JavaScript. And this should hopefully now throw an error. And so to test that, we're going to say when this is validated, we want to change. Oops, to change. My hands were just slightly off to the left there. That's awesome. But we want to change our record.errors count. And yeah, let's see what this does. Let's go to line 14 here. Okay, unexpected message with no args. Fantastic. Okay, I know what I've done wrong there. It's active record errors. Silly me. Cool, there we go. So we now know this is kind of would render an error. Let's quickly check this code because we didn't do TDD before. So let's remove that. Let's put that in. There we go. When we comment out this line, this test now fails really perfectly. It says, hey, I'm still at zero. And then if we put it back in again, it's there, which is nice. Let's also check something else about this. Let's be like, and change record.errors.firstType to equal. So we want to check what the first type is. I only put an and in there. I think that was out of habit. Let's just see what this is. What's this going to be? It should be invalid, I think. So it's complained here that type is nil. So the reason I think I put this in is for my notes. But yeah, when we first, the way the change works is it kind of pulls the value out initially, runs this code here, and then checks it again. So let's try that again. Nice. So it said, oh, cool. It's saying, hey, this is meant to be invalid. Nice. So that's saying, hey, the first error on this field or in our record should be an invalid type. And that's the one we've added in there. So let's quickly check that is correct here. Yep, that's all good. We've run the whole file, which is even nicer. And let's quickly change this to be like not valid. If we were to give this a different name, what happens? That test should fail nice and loudly. There we go. It should have changed this value to equal invalid, but it's now not valid. Perfect. Okay. We should probably add something to check that if we add a value which is, actually acceptable, it'll work as well. So let's do like happy fields. And we're going to say, hey, we want it to run that code. There's nothing in there which should, render an error. And so don't change the error count, bro. Right? Have a look at that. Perfect. And we can totally just double check that is working. Get rid of all of this. Nice. So that test we just wrote will fail if that code does not work. Nice. So the cool thing here is we can now start refactoring this filter very specifically. So if I wanted to actually handle multiple words or do something more interesting with these values, I could. So that's nice. I said I was going to explain this. So this is quite cool. So if I remove this is something quirky I kind of found. It would again argument error. And I think Rails kind of expects it to be there, I guess. I have no idea why, but I had to add it. So just an FYI on why that is there. But yeah, so that's the tutorial done. If you want to add custom validators, which are reusable and really nice in my opinion, and aren't like little private methods, which are very model specific, you can add a really nice one like this. And I'm gonna whack in the link to the docs as well, because there's even more you can do with these things. Cool. That's the end of this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you again next time. Bye.